About 2 years ago, I believe, or maybe a year ago, I made a video like this, just the camera and my face, where I talked about review scores, and how I believed review scores are really harmful to the industry, at least when professional journalists use it. I was kind of in thought that that if users like user reviews use review scores, I mean that's okay because it's a user's opinion. And it's actually more easy to filter out what kind of reviews I want to read when there's so many user reviews, and there's no way you could check out all of them. So it's a good way to see that, oh, this person thinks this game is a 7 or 6, kind of sees a summary, and then you can maybe read about why that person thinks so. I thought that was kind of okay, but at the same time, I was kind of heavily against the idea of the industry using review scores, and that was a fairly long video, as I'm sure this one probably will be too. Because I was just thinking, if a game is scored too high, then it's really hard to talk about the bad points of the game, and every game has a bad point. And if the game is scored too low, it's the scoring aspect makes it seem like there's way too much justification going on in the review. And I guess that's just what I didn't really like to see in this industry, where critiquing it or reviewing a game for a consumer's benefit could be much more informative and enlightening without the little m number or grade that's attached at the end. So I'm revisiting this topic in this video because I think I kind of have overlooked the complexity of this issue, where I would still really love to see gaming scores reviewed from all websites, all professional gaming websites out there. But at the same time, I guess I gotta be a little bit more realistic on this one, because there is some little complex issues involved here, as I'm sure most of you, or many of you, are probably aware of. Is a site like Metacritic, it using scores that are not on the norm does get that website's more recognition, and also for it's a good. The Metacritic score is very important to many publishers. Some people's payroll depends on that average, which I thought to be quite surprising. It's just the score is more than just, informative score or just an opinion nowadays. It's actually like a verdict of some sort of money arrangement that goes on. I guess there was a scandal, if you guys remember, with the GameSpot and Jeff Gerstmann, I believe is his name. Well, he and his Kane and Lynch review, where he I guess the problem was that he rated it too low, like 60 or something, and so the company, GameSpot, let him go. Or this is just speculation. I'm not really sure what happened with that. But this is kind of an industry where gaming scores can have that kind of impact. So I guess I'm kind of overlooking this. I mean, all these are negative things in my opinion. I mean, gaming scores should not be used this way at all. If anything, they should just be opinions and think, they should just act as kind of a summary of what that review is, because some reviews can be extremely long. IGN reviews, some reviews can be 6 pages, 10 pages. Their GTA 4 review was that long, because, well, although most of the GTA 4 review was trying to justify why they gave it a score of 10, so most paragraphs like that weren't needed. I didn't think it was deserved to be needed. But, some reviews are really long, so I guess for consumers who don't want to read that much, a score or a grade, I guess, can be helpful in a way, although it is my personal opinion that they should still just read it because it's $60 they're spending. With that kind of money investment, yes, they should read all of it. They should read what's good for them, what's not good for them. No, just going by numbers alone, that's going to lead to a lot of disappointments and a lot of missed opportunities. So that was my argument there, but I am missing the complexity here. And also, the websites, some websites, in order to be recognized, they have to get a Metacritic. And Metacritic requires scores. Gaming websites that are small, they're not just going to get their name out there and get sponsors and advertisers just by saying, "Here's a review, there's no score," because they don't want to Metacritic, they don't get seen by other viewers. And when viewers, mostly these websites, I found myself discovering new gaming websites because of Metacritic, actually. Because I was just like, "Oh, this looks like an interesting site." I clicked on it and I read the review, was like, "This is a brilliantly written review." And you know, I discovered a site like that. So in a way, for small websites out there that really want to get more known to the public, this is really great stuff to use scores like that. I'm not really against any of that whatsoever. So realistically speaking, I realize that there's a lot more complex issues here than just saying review scores are principally in principle wrong, so they should not be used. I mean, I still kind of believe that, but I guess it's just there's a lot of obstacles and difficulties to be had in order for review scores to be removed. So that's just kind of issues I wanted to touch up on this revisit of the topic of review scores. Yeah, so that's it.